Hello everyone, welcome to today's webcast. My name is Patrick, I'm a SOLIDWORKS application engineer, and today we're going to be continuing to take a look at some SOLIDWORKS tools that'll help you improve your efficiency by automating parts of your design process. So first off, I just want to take a look at SOLIDWORKS Task Scheduler. If you've not seen it before, SOLIDWORKS Task Scheduler is a tool that lets you set up tasks to be performed at a future time. You can set up these tasks just to be performed once, or daily, weekly, or even on a monthly basis. Task Scheduler comes with every license of SOLIDWORKS, but the majority of tasks are only available if you have a professional or premium license. So what tasks are there? You can see there's quite a few I'm listing out here. Only the first couple are available to standard licenses, but they'll all be available if you have a professional license. And I don't want to explain every single one, but I'll just point out a few major ones here. So convert files is available to everyone, and it's really good if you want to take files that were created in an older version of SOLIDWORKS and save them into the latest version. It's a good idea to do that if you've got large file sets or if you've skipped a couple of years when you've upgraded, because files tend to work better once they've been saved in the latest version. Print files, import files, and export files all do what they sound like, but allow you to do it en masse. So let's say you had 100 drawings to print from a project that's just been improved. You don't really want to have to open up every single drawing and print them manually yourself. Using Task Scheduler, you can just select the folder and tell it to print all of those drawings and it'll take care of the rest for you. You can also create drawings with Task Scheduler, create e-drawings, and what I'm going to actually have a look at first is this task here called Design Checker. Now, Design Checker is actually available outside Task Scheduler, and I just want to introduce it before we look at how it could maybe work with Task Scheduler. So Design Checker is a tool that allows you just to double check or sort of verify certain design choices and elements, such as like fonts or materials used in your parts or drawings. Typically, it's most useful when checking drawings, and it's a really helpful tool because not only can it find errors for you, it can also actually automatically correct some of them. However, before it knows how to check a drawing, we need to tell it what to look for. So the first step I'm going to have is in this drawing here, well, in the process of checking this drawing here, is going to be to build a design check. So if I go up to Tools, I can then go down to Design Checker, go for Build Checks, and that's going to launch a new window where I can create a new standards file for my check. So down the left, there's a load of different checks that I can add in. You don't necessarily need to use all of these, just add in the things that are important to you. So I'm going to get it to check for an ISO standard. I'm also currently setting it up to check for a custom property. It's going to check for the drawn by custom property, and it's going to make sure that it's being created by me, or at least that I've remembered to put my initials into it. I'm setting the document units. Just make sure it's being done in millimeters, grams, seconds rather than inches. And I'm also going to make sure the correct fonts are used. By setting things like this, you can, and using Design Checker as well, you can ensure some consistency between your drawings. So I'm setting the fonts for both notes and dimensions. If I was being really picky, I could set the sizes as well, but I'm just setting the overall font for now. So the checks on the left currently aren't actually all the checks. If you see at the top, there are actually some more tabs. I'm going to explore them now, and we're going to add in some more checks from those tabs as well. So this one, I'm going to add in a check for overridden dimensions or dimensions where the text has been replaced. This is great for spotting any sort of bodged dimensions. So if anyone's manually changed one of the dimensions to not match what the model shows, then you can spot it really quickly using Design Checker. Again, just checking the dimensions units are going to be in millimeters, and I'm going to set it just to check for one decimal place. You can see I'm making that a medium criticality check, so it's not quite as important as some of the other checks. This will just change how the overall design checker feeds that information back to us once we've run it. Final check I'm going to add in here is for overlapping views look really messy and make it hard to understand the drawing, so I'm setting that to be a critical error. Right, and now I've just saved that check, I'm ready to use it. So I'll close down out of this window once it's saved, I don't need it any longer. And I'm going to go for Tools, Design Checker, and Check Active Document to check this drawing. There's a load of checks in there already, so Before I actually run check document, I need to just take those out and put in my custom check instead. So I've added my custom check into that list, and I'm just going to untick the other ones because I don't want to check by those standards. Hitting check document, it'll now give me a list of the different errors, sorting them by their criticality. So you can see the most critical errors are showing at the top, which is the overlapping views. To fix that, I'll just drag the views apart. The top views obviously had a large problem. The bottom views isn't actually so much of an issue. Their borders are overlapping, but the geometry is actually well clear of it. So although I'm going to leave it in a position where the error will be reported because the borders are overlapping, I've at least looked at it and sort of verified that it's not actually a big issue. Hitting the refresh button, those double green arrows at the top, it's now disappeared the main issue that I had, which was the top two views. That's been corrected, so it's now disappeared from that list. Looking at the results of some of these other checks, I can see that some incorrect fonts have been used. So for some reason, Comic Sans was using this drawing. That really should have been set to be critical. No one would ever print a drawing with Comic Sans on, I'd hope. And there are a few other less important issues as well there. And what I'm actually going to use is this button called Autocorrect. And that's going to just correct everything that it can. So any incorrect fonts, any incorrect dimension standard, it should find and correct for me straight away. Now, some other issues have popped up after I ran that. For example, the dimension precisions are now showing up, and they're showing up as being three decimal places where I only want one. But by running autocorrect again, that's able to fix it for me. There's some things that it can't fix, like the overlapping views. It wouldn't want to randomly reposition your views, so you'd have to fix that for yourself. And the other one that I'm just going to fix up is this custom property. So I wanted it to make sure that in the custom properties of this file, it's written my initials and the drawn by. That's not currently even in there at all. So I'm going to add in a drawn by property and then just add my initials there. Okay, when I hit the refresh, that error then disappears. So moving on, this check, I built it to check this drawing, but it is actually a universal check. It can be used to check any drawing. So we'll just have another quick example on this drawing here. So you can see maybe a couple of issues straight away. Those views are a little bit close to each other. If I run check active document, it remembers what checks I used last time, and it's feeding back all those errors for me. I'll use autocorrect all after I correct the two overlapping views, and that should fix almost everything that I need to fix up. So I've just refreshed after correcting the overlapping views, and now when I go for autocorrect all, you can see there's only a couple of problems left. There's two overlapping dimensions, and they're only overlapping on the leader lines, so they're not too important in terms of errors. There's also that missing custom property from my initials, but I've just shown you how to fix that, so I won't show it again just because that'll get pretty time-consuming if I show it on every drawing we open up. Okay, last drawing that we're going to look at now. And this one is in a better state than the last two, but we'll run check document one more time. It's still finding some issues with the fonts and the dimensioning standard used. I'm just going to go straight to autocorrect all, and that corrects every error that I'm worried about here. And there was actually an ulterior reason why I opened up this drawing. I want to create a drawing template for it, so it's ready for us to use within Task Scheduler. So I'm just going to save this drawing first after doing the corrections, and then to create the drawing template, I just need to save the drawing again, but change the file type. So if I go for save as, change the file type to drawing templates, I'm going to save it out of the default template location and just give it a name that makes sense. So I'm going to call it three views ISO. Once I save this drawing, what it's going to do is everywhere there was a view in the original drawing, it's going to turn them into blank views. So we're ready to use other part files with this drawing template. If I use this drawing template in combination with the part file, it's going to create a front, top and right view for me straight away, as well as that colored isometric in the top corner. I made one final change there, just changing it to use hidden lines removed in the drawings views rather than hidden lines visible. Okay, so we're ready to move on to Task Scheduler, and I'm just going to set up three tasks and we'll just see the outputs of each one. So I'm going to use Task Scheduler to update custom properties for those three drawings. I'm also going to generate some new drawings out of a different folder and create some e-drawings as well. So you can see all the tasks I mentioned earlier listed on the left-hand side there. And the first one I'm going to go for is update custom properties. I need to just tell it which files I want to update. And I've done it by choosing add folder. So I just need to pick the folder and it will select all the files within. Then I need to choose what time I want this task to run at. So I'm just going to set that a few minutes in the future so I've got time to set up my other tasks. Hit next, and then I need to add in the custom properties that I want to change. Any custom property that's already in a file will be updated with this new value. If something isn't in the file, it'll be added into it. So I'm adding in drawn by and putting my initials again, and I'm also adding in drawn date and just typing in today's date. This will add those two properties to all the files. But you can use this to add essentially any property you need. So let's say you forgot to add a material for an entire assembly's worth of parts. Rather than open them all up individually, you could use that task to add it all automatically for you. So here I'm going into the create drawings task, and I just need to select a drawing template. So I'm going to select the drawing template I created a second ago, and then I'm going to tell it which parts I want to make a drawing for. So I've organized this already into that folder, and I just need to select the folder itself, and that's picked all the parts within it. Again, I'm going to set the time just to happen in a few minutes. And the final thing I'm setting here is where I want it to output those drawings. If you don't change anything, it'll just output it to the same folder, which is usually quite a good idea. But just to keep things tidy, I've made another folder to send those drawings to. All right, so those are two tasks scheduled now. Neither of them will start running until the appointed time. And so I've got time to just set up one more task. And this is going to just be for creating the e-drawings. That folder contains all the parts I want to make e-drawings for. And the output folder I'm just setting here as well. And final thing I'm going to set before the time is I'm just going to change the e-drawings export options a little bit so that the files will be allowed to be measurable. You can actually configure whether you want your files to be measured or not with e-drawings. Okay, so jumping forward, rather than making you watch half an hour of task running, we have these completed tasks now, and for each task you can open up a report to see which tasks or which parts have been successful, and it will give you a detailed report back for every sub-element of the task that it's run. So what I'm doing now is just opening up one of the drawings that the task has created, and you can see it's created those three views plus an isometric view. Now, it's not going to be fit for sending out just yet, this drawing. Obviously, it's missing any sort of dimensions or annotations. It can't completely do your work for you, task scheduler. But if you had a load of drawings to create, it might just cut off a minute or two for each part that you wanted to create a drawing for. So it's quite a worthwhile pursuit anyway. Having a look at these e-drawings, then you can see I've opened one of them up. And it's exactly as I expect. It's created a perfect e-drawing off the part. So one last task just to check the success of, and this is the custom properties. So we're going to switch back to one of those drawings earlier. And just check out its custom properties. And I should find both drawn by and drawn date in there. Okay, so three successful tasks. That's just a fraction of what task scheduler can do. But to wrap up this webcast, I just want to talk about some alternatives as well, just in case you're not convinced about automation just yet. So as well as Task Scheduler, there's a great online application you can download for free called #Task. It's not actually made by us and not directly affiliated with us either, but it's a really useful free application, so I thought I'd mention it. It's worth checking out. It can even do a couple of things that Task Scheduler can't do, such as export sheet metal DXFs directly from sheet metal parts. SOLIDWORKS macros are really great if you need to automate any part of the SOLIDWORKS software. You can use them to in a much more versatile manner than any other sort of automation tool, but you do require some prior knowledge to be able to really set them up. They're not that easy to get going with. And then the final tool that I want to mention is DriveWorks. If you've not seen DriveWorks before, I strongly recommend you check it out. We've got some webcasts on it that you can have a look at just to get an idea of it. And essentially, it allows you to create a huge number of variations from any model you create, and it sort of works on a rules-based setup. So once it's been configured, anyone can really use it. So you can have either your sales team or even customers configure their own perfect variation of one of your models. And that's where I'm going to end today's webcast. I hope it's been useful for you. Maybe you've learned a thing or two about automation. Please do check out our other webcasts, and goodbye for now.